the Belmont saxophone, Pat Guidano, ladies and gentlemen. Jim Celestino on guitar, Red River Rizzo on the bass, Joe Belli on percussion, Arna Went in the back on the board. Come on over here, Purdie. Man, oh, you sound so good. Look at you, my man. You're doing right, you feel good. You look good, you feel good, you're doing everything right.
Well, I'm trying.
3,000 albums, you have to be exhausted, my friend.
Well,
you gotta be tired.
I didn't get tired until I passed that mark. So I'm closer to 4,000 now.
Is that right? That's just, you know, I was reading up about you in preparation for the show, and there were hours of information. Just hours of information. And what I love about you, we're talking a little bit about this, you can go right into any type of genre. You go into jazz, which your forte is wonderful, blues, soul, rock and roll, and anything, you know, you go from is amazing. And it's almost like a switch. How do you turn that on and off?
Well, the hard part for me was listening to my teacher. Finally, I did, and he forced me to learn music.
And that was it?
That was it. And he says, it's all about concept. Everything that you do, music itself, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what genre you're in. The notes don't change. Everything that you do, it's all about feel. Make it feel good.
And you started, I mean, you're 3 years old. Yeah, how about it? You're one of 15 kids.
Yes.
You're one of 15. He was one of 15 children. And you know, I mean, playing drums, you started at the age of three.
Started at three.
And got really good like at six.
Yes.
How does that happen? Your 15 kids are gonna say, hey, I wanna play the drums. How does that work with in the middle of a family of 15?
Well, it didn't work so well in the beginning. I was fortunate enough that my mother allowed me to play on the pots and pans from three to six.
Is that right?
By the time I was six, she got a new set of pots and pans.
It was you were styling that.
Yeah, but the only problem was she wouldn't let me play on it. See those? Yes, they're mine. Those are yours. So
you had the old pots and pans.
I had to stay with the old pots and pans.
And so really, when all of a sudden did you, at what age, because in high school, or just about going into high school, at that age, at 14, you really started to come around.
Well, actually, I kind of did that before then, because I had, by that time, I was had my own band by the time I was 12.
But, 12 years old.
Playing a big band by 8 years old. That was my teacher, and it was the Clyde Bessie's Orchestra. So I did everything that you're supposed to do. The hard part was to go to work.
Yeah. Well, but we were talking about, I mean, one of those, you learned how to read music at a very early age.
Yes.
So learning that music and then understanding what the words, what the music was in front of you, and then all of a sudden, but your twist, your interpretation of that was what made you so famous.
Wow. Thank you.
You're damn right.
For me, it was, I had to learn what everyone else was doing. So you have to know what the music is all about. And my teacher told me that one day what I was doing was going to happen. I just figured he would tell me that to shut me up. But was normal.
It worked.
It worked.
But I'm going to take you back into the early 70s when the queen of soul, Aretha Franklin. Aretha Franklin says, she's going to do this. She's going to make some great music. But it's you that's going to make it with it. Meaning,
yes.
Tell the story about, tell the queen of soul story.
Well, what happened after being with her for a few years with King Curtis. We were in Ohio, and I had done a talk show on CNN. And during the course of that time, I, you know, very happy, you know. And I mentioned that when Aretha sings, she's singing to me. And when I play, I'm playing for her. Well, that went on CNN, and it was on a Sunday. That evening, we were doing the show, 18,000 people, and we had wonderful, I mean, it, great. It was one of the best shows we had done. And it was time we do our last number, and she wants to, folks want an encore. She stops the band. She stops the band. She said, ladies and gentlemen, you have to forgive me, but I have to tell you what's going on. In order for me to do an encore tonight, I have to ask my drummer. What? The band turned around and looked at me. She says, my drummer said that I'm singing to him. So in order for me to sing to him, I have to ask if we can do this encore. Woo! The audience went crazy. Yeah, Purdie, let her have it. Let her sing. Have anything to do with it. It'll make me feel so bad. But the band rubbed it in. And then I had to say, I said, payback.
Payback.
Payback. It took me 2 weeks, but payback.
Okay. And payback you did. I have to read this partial list of who you perform with and in sessions. Do you mind? I'm sorry.
Okay. Go right ahead.
Aretha, Herbie Mann, Miles Davis, Todd Rundgren, Cat Stevens, Steely Dan, The Asia Album, B.B. King, Joe Cocker, Isaac Hayes, Sweet Lou Donaldson, Hall & Oates, You Ain't Concessions for the Rolling Stones, James Brown, Tom Jones, Al Green, Marvin Gaye, Michael Jackson, Alan Jackson, King Curtis, Count Basie, Duke Ellington, and on and on and on. I had to do that. I don't mean to embarrass you. I had to do that. The list, you gotta go to bernardpurdie.com. I want you to go there because, and I said immediately, and then I found it. There, you gotta have a book. I mean, of all these things, and it's gonna happen.
It's happening.
It's happening.
Now. It's officially out October.
It's been in the works for years.
15 years.
15 years he's been working on it. And I got to tell you something. I'm thrilled. I can't wait till it comes out because...
I'm very, very happy.
The stories and the sessions and just the pleasure that you brought to people through your music is phenomenal. I'm thrilled that you're here. And when we come back, we kick us off with another song.
Oh, I'd be glad to.
Look at this. The legend, ladies and gentlemen. Bernard Pretty Purdie. We'll be right back on the Big Joe Henry Variety Show. Don't go away. More from Bernard coming up. Standing ovation, everybody. Look at that.